My name is Karen Carver. I am the program director for the oral and maxillofacial surgery residency here at the University of Michigan. My practice is primarily centered around pediatric oral surgery, and so I work in CS Mott Children's Hospital in addition to my administrative duties over in the main hospital. We have an assistant program director. His name is Paul Shivers, and we have our section head, who is currently Dr. Brent Ward. We have one chief resident that will typically act as an administrative chief, scheduling, et cetera. We have one who typically acts as an education chief and is responsible for promoting most of our educational initiatives and organizing conferences. And then our third chief is typically responsible for our perioperative care, implants, surgical planning, that. First and foremost, I want trainees or prospective trainees to find a program that fits well for them, that aligns with their values and ultimately what they want to do with their career and their goals as an oral surgeon. So when they come here, we want this program to feel like the best place for them and the best fit for them to train in for the 6 years of their life that they're here with us. Beyond that, we want them to go out and do great things in the community. And whatever that means to them, we want to be supportive and help them get there. If they want to open a private practice and focus exclusively on private practice oral surgery, we're thrilled to support that. If they want to pursue fellowship training, or if they want to adopt a training or practice model that maybe hasn't been more common in our specialty, also thrilled to support that. But basically, we want them to go out in the community with the Block M being a huge part of their training and give back in the ways that they're most capable. We are probably one of the larger departments in the country. We have a large number of full-time faculty, which I think is pretty unique. We also have a large number of fellowship-trained faculty. So those faculty that are have pursued additional training in head and neck oncology, in craniofacial training. The bench is quite deep, and so we have a very diverse faculty that can contribute really in a significant way to resident education. We cover multiple age ranges, multiple diagnoses, and so I really do think when you leave here, you've been exposed to all oral surgery has to offer. We have three current head and neck oncology surgeons. We have three other surgeons who are, myself included, craniofacial trained. And then we have one faculty member who's both pediatric and craniofacial trained and kind of crosses over. In addition to that, we have a fantastic dental school presence that's very important, very valued to us. So when you match into the program here, you first start out for just a quick month over at the dental school to kind of get your feet wet, and operate primarily, you know, return to your dental alveolar experience fresh out of dental school. After that, we'll send you off to medical school for about 2 years, and you get a really well-rounded full medical school experience and get to take advantage of all the great things that the Michigan Medical School is able to offer, really as an integrated part of the class. After those 2 years, you'll come back and transition into your general surgery and anesthesia time. And so you will leave after that time with a 2-year certificate in general surgery when you graduate. And then the last about 2.5 years of the program, the latter part is all focused on oral surgery. And so that's when you kind of come back and really get your feet wet, start as a junior and work your way up to the chief level at the back end of your training. The great part about that is that we can really have sequential experiences that build on your knowledge base, build on the experiences that you've had, and really can kind of progress you through your clinical years in a thoughtful and intentional way. We get to see everything from kind of the more basic routine things that you might expect to see in oral surgery. So dental alveolar experiences, extraction of wisdom teeth and third molars, implants, bone grafting, kind of the what you would expect in an outpatient oral surgery setting. Temporomandibular joint surgery is something that we do a frequent amount of. Orthognathic and jaw surgery, cleft and craniofacial care, head and neck oncology, including microvascular and free flap experiences. So I think as a resident here, you get to see really the wide breadth of experiences, but you also get to sink your teeth into some of those more, the less common diagnoses and the more complex patients. And I think you get to work in a really multidisciplinary environment. You'll have experiences at head and neck tumor board. You'll have experiences collaborating with other services, including our hospital dentistry team. That's sort of the other arm of our section. So you get to see oral surgery across multiple settings and across multiple areas of subspecialty practice. Once you come from your medical school years and you start transitioning into those resident years, that's when you really integrate with the Department of General Surgery and with the Department of Anesthesia. So you'll spend 5 months on anesthesia and then the remainder of that time will be general surgery time. And the rotations and the month-long experiences that you have on general surgery can be varied depending on the resident schedule, but pretty much always will include an ICU, a robust ICU experience, a time spent on our otolaryngology and plastic surgery services, and then a really wide breadth of other general surgery experiences. And that can include anything from minimally invasive thyroid to colorectal. Just it spans the gap depending on the service schedule or depending on the general surgery schedule. One of the, I think, beneficial things is that we have a really kind of robust home base here at the hospital. So as a resident, you're not covering multiple hospitals at once and driving in the middle of the night to try and, you know, make it to three different sites. We work primarily out of our dental school outpatient clinical site. We work in our CS Small Children's Hospital, and then we work in our main university hospital. And that's where our clinics and operating rooms are all located. We do occasionally receive consults from other outside hospitals and operate at a few other off-sites, but the vast bulk of the work happens here in one connected building. So our educational curriculum follows essentially a Monday morning case conference where we review cases for the week. And then we also have our Wednesday educational conferences. And on our Thursdays, we have a variety of conferences and include things like our morbidity and mortality conference, as well as our journal clubs reviewing primary scientific literature. So that's what happens pretty much on a weekly basis. But then on top of that, whenever possible, we try and incorporate other educational experiences. That looks like simulation experiences, getting the chance to try different equipment. We have a cadaveric dissection lab that happens every year where we can practice surgical exposures. And students, residents, and faculty can kind of work through those things together. And then residents are able to take advantage of any educational opportunities that they look forward to outside of the hospital and their training, which can include things like national conferences or collaboration with other institutions. One of the other initiatives that residents often take advantage of is an observership program that goes through an outside organization where they get to spend a little bit of time in private practice and get exposure to the way other practitioners might do things. We do value research. That's obviously part of the mission of the Department of Surgery. And there are research expectations for our residents as they come through. We request that they publish and have a robust research experience while they're here, whether that's presenting a paper or being a part of a presentation at a national conference. Every resident that comes through will have some sort of meaningful research experience. And there are a variety of ways that we can support that. So whether it's within the department, working with one specific faculty member, if the resident wants to collaborate with other departments, if they'd like to look at some of the great centers and initiatives that Michigan has, those are all options that we would be happy to support. I think a lot of the mentorship happens through research projects, number one, but also I think, if there's defined interests that any particular student has, we can certainly find a faculty member who's able to help further those interests. I think that goes back to having a large number of full-time faculty and also adjunct faculty that have varied interests as well. So as a resident here, you know, whatever subject matter you're looking for mentorship in, whether it's just general, whether it's research specific, whether it's how do I do the next steps and how do I get into private practice, there are people here who can kind of partner with you on that and help you advance those goals. We support resident wellness, I think, at an individual level and with the culture of the program, certainly. We give all of our residents full access to everything that's available at the university and hospital level in terms of resident wellness. We like to have at least regular meetings with our residents in terms of retreats and in terms of regular checking in with the residents to make sure that they're happy, that things are going well, and that they're having their needs met. We support our residents financially as well in terms of providing support for research and conferences and for resident travel whenever appropriate, connecting them with any outside opportunities that can be helpful or supportive to them, and also through supporting their medical school tuition as well. As a resident, you also have the opportunity to be part of a House Officers Association, which is an organization that's existing for the support of House officers and ensuring that they have the best experience that they can while they're here. One of the things that we're really the most proud of here is our culture. I think we have a really fantastic group of approachable people who are a joy to work with, who care about their job, and who really come to work and try and do their best every day. And that's from the ground up. That's from every person who's involved in the department, including our residents. So it's a nice place to train. It's a comfortable environment. It's a supportive environment. And we really look at each resident as an individual and try to focus on all the ways that we can make them thrive as an oral surgeon and as a person as they go through this program.